Hello, my name is Vadim Mikhalenko, and I would like to introduce you how to create annual budget in Microsoft Excel. So I'm gonna jump to Microsoft Excel, and we're gonna look at different things that needs to be part of the budget. From the high level, budget consists of income and expenses. So the basic concept of building the budget is for you to try to make sure that all your expenses meet all your incomes, and all the money that coming in, they balance with the expenses that's coming out. So let's look at the major category. I'm gonna set up an income category, and I'm gonna set up an expenses category. And in the income category, what we might have, we'll have a consulting arrangement with the vendor. And I'm gonna create a couple more lines, just insert them. And we also, in the income category, are gonna have a computer support for the client. And we're gonna have a writing guest blog posts. Some of you may have this, some of you may have different categories here. This is just imaginary freelancer that's getting income from doing the different job assignments over the year. So I'm gonna make this category bold, and we're gonna try to project money that's coming in here. And this is on the annual basis. So I'm gonna mark this as annual. So this would be $25,000. Computer support from the client, this would be $10,000. And writing guest blog posts would be $3,000, right? And what I'm also gonna do, I'm just gonna mark them as dollars so it's easy to read. Now let's look at the expenses. In the expenses, we might have at least two different categories. We might have some ongoing expenses, and we might have debt servicing expenses. And you might have more, everybody's situation is different, but I'll just focus on those two. I will look at breaking down this into ongoing expenses, and I'm gonna also some debt servicing. And in the debt servicing category, you might have the credit cards, you might have student loans, you might have your car loans or some other loans. This is basically money that you got on credit and you need to repay. So in this case, you don't need to pay the full amount, but you rather may pay some percentage or some pretty fine fixed amount. So in ongoing expenses, we might have electrical bill, right? We might have phone bills. We might have cable, groceries. And let me insert a couple more categories here. And we may have gas, assuming I'll have two cars. I'll have Honda Civic and I'll have Ford Accord. So gas for Honda Civic, gas for Ford Accord. Then I'll also might have some medical expenses, and I'll have some dining expenses. This might be visiting restaurants or some other form of entertainment. And in a debt servicing category, I will have mortgage or rent. I mean, if it's rent, then it becomes the ongoing expense category. But if it's mortgage, it's a debt servicing category. And this is formal dividing. The importance of this is that you need to plan to repay debt differently from the ongoing expenses. And then the assumption, another assumption here is that your car is still in repayment. For example, you might have... your both cars are still have loans, And you need to make monthly payment for each of your cars. So I'm gonna say Honda Civic monthly payment, Ford Accord monthly payment, student loan 1, student loan 2, and then you have Discover card, and then we will have Capital One Visa card, and we will have personal loan with Chase. So these are my categories, right? And I'm gonna zoom out a little bit so we can see more information here, and I'm just gonna make this categories bold. So these are my major categories, and I can also do this. So this way we can see everything. Now, in terms of expenses, the way to organize the expenses, we just need to list the monthly amount, and I'm gonna insert another column here, and I'm just gonna say that this is gonna be monthly amount, and for ongoing expenses, I'm just gonna say, okay, this is my electrical bill is $100, so annual expense would be $1,200, right? Phone bill would be $500. Okay, so we're doing monthly, so $100, then $50. Cable would be $70. Groceries, assumption here is that there are two people living together, so the monthly bill would be $500. Gasoline is about $200. Ford Accord, $250. Medical, let's say $300. And dining would be monthly $300. But again, I'm going to mark them as dollar amounts. And what I'm going to do in the annual column, I'm going to say, okay, as annual amounts, this is going to be my monthly amount multiplied by 12. And that's how am I going to calculate my annual expense amount in the ongoing expense category. And instead of copying this and entering it individually for each cell, I'm going to just copy this cell, Control C and then Control V, I'm going to paste it in. So my total in the ongoing expense category is going to be $21,240. So, and let's look at my income. So my income is total for the year is going to be 38,000, and my expenses in ongoing expense category are 21,240 categories. $21,240 total. So let's look at the debt servicing. I left two columns here, and I'm going to have two different things. The debt is a little bit different, remember I told you. So we have overall balance on the debt, and we will have monthly payment, and we will have annual payment. Something that we need to plan for the entire year. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to insert another column and shift the whole thing to the left a little bit. So we'll have a way to insert the balance, and we don't need such high column, such wide column for the monthly expenses. But the overall balance on the mortgage might be under $20,000, right? Honda Civic balance would be $4,500. Accord monthly, Accord, and I'm probably gonna rename the category so we wouldn't say it's a monthly payment, because we will clarify it. for a court, it's going to be $3,000. Student loan, $15,000. $17,000. Discover card balance would be $750. Capital Visa, $500. And personal loan with Chase would be $3,000. So I'm going to mark them as dollar amounts again. And I am going to now enter the monthly payment. So the mortgage would be $350, Honda Civic repayment $125, this would be $110 monthly, student loan, assuming nothing, because I just graduated from college, so I'm not in the repayment phase yet. I still have 1 year before I start repaying. Discover card, we will have a monthly payment of $50. Capital One Visa card is will have $40, and for personal loan we will have $120. So for annual we can reuse the same formula, which would be equal my monthly amount multiplied by 12, and I'm just gonna send it through, and my annual expenses would be totaling in this category $9,540, and I'm just going to mark it here as dollars with dollar sign, and this would be my total. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to also gonna make those bold. I'm gonna do some estimation. I would like to make sure that my total income, planned income, does not exceed my total expenses. And the way I'm gonna do it, I'm just gonna say my income minus and my total expense in the ongoing expense category plus my total expense in the debt servicing category. And I'm just going to calculate that. So it looks like if I 38,000 minus 21,000 plus 9,540 equals 7,220. So that's good. I have some surplus, meaning that I have some extra funds here. And what I can start doing with this extra funds, I can start paying a little bit more toward my debt servicing to lower my principals, because here I'm assuming that I'm only making the minimum payments on the credit cards. And we have a special lesson here on how to repay the debt. So this was the creation of the annual budget class, and I appreciate you watching this video. You can find more at howtoanalyzedata.net. We focus on answering the business questions with data and focusing on delivering business value for you. My name is Vadim Mikhailenko, and I appreciate you watching this video. And I'll see you again on the howtoanalyzedata.net. At How to Analyze Data, we focus on delivering value to you. We bring up the experts that share information on the subject. We also focus on high quality audio and video for easy for you to consuming and remembering the information. And we also provide you all sample files from the applications that have been discussed as part of the training videos. And the key piece is that all videos focus on solving real business problems. We take a simple question and we try to answer simple business questions. Obviously, you can find out more by visiting howtoanalyzedata.net website. We have a lot more videos. Some of them are still in progress and coming up. But you will find how to answer sales business questions with data, how to analyze and answer marketing business questions with data, HR, finance, and small business questions with data. And you can always submit your own business questions, and we welcome and we will try to answer all of them. Thanks for watching. Again, my name is Vadim Mikhailenko from howtoanalyzedata.net.